new products. New. All
right. Okay, so let's go through the first batch. These are the fluorescent.
Yeah, we put in the thermochromic inks, powders, and now we have this pressed powder that's UV reactive. So this is pink color. It comes in, a little plastic tin. And then we have one drawing. It's the same drawing, but you can see all the different colors. Under UV, it glows this beautiful bright color. You also have purple. In the same photo, you can see the purple. Green, which is like really vivid. And that's the Adafruit Star. And yellow, which is also very vivid. The yellows and greens are very vivid, but the pinks and purples are too. And there's more colors that they were available in, but these look the best. So we sort of started with these, and we only wanted to carry ones that we thought would look really good under UV LED or blacklight. So you can mix this with almost any material you like, whether it be water or wax or plastic, and make something that glows under blacklight.
All right, next up.
We also have what Philby calls the deluxe party tray of buttons. So the place I get my silicone buttons from also had this available, and I was like, this is the coolest thing ever. Wish I had it to show to you, but it basically is an 8-segmented case, and you get the case, and each one of them, I think, has about 20 LED and 20 6mm tactile buttons, and each button has a different colored top. So if you can go to the next photo, you get red, orange, yellow, green, blue, brown, white, and black. You get a wide range of colors, and they're all the same 6mm tactile buttons that you're used to using in a breadboard, but you get this like deluxe party tray. So you can take this on the go and snack on them, whatever you like. No, don't snack on them. But yeah, you can see each little thing opens up individually.
All right, next up.
Next up, we have two more battery packs. These are open style battery packs, so they're lighter and easier to remove the batteries, but they also don't have on-off switches. We have them as a 2 AAA, and also we have a matching 2 AA one. These give you about 2.7 to 2 volts, basically, from alkalines, and then 2.2 to 2.8 volts with nickel metal hydrides. These are really good for use with Microbit, if we wanted to carry like an alternative battery pack for use with Microbit, but it can be used for other projects where you only need about 2 to 3 volts to power them. So now we have we have 2, 3, and 4 AA and AAA battery cases.
And to be clear, these do come with the case.
Yes, you get the case.
Yeah.
And you get 20 of each color.
Yep.
160 total.
Okay.
It's a low, low cost.
And then at the start of the show tonight, besides Yuli Data, the community, the open source groups that we all met with, is these wheels.
Michael. This is a really nice wheel. This is a rubber wheel for robotics. We carry a couple different wheels, but I like this one in particular because it can be used three ways. When you get the wheel, it has these two little plastic pieces that you can pop out, or they might come loose. And they can convert, by default, it has a cross, and that cross is Lego compatible. So if you've ever done Lego robotics, you know that the axles have this cross shape. So that will fit onto the wheel. So you can use this for any of your Lego robot projects. It's a nice rubber wheel with treads on it. I think it's about 65 millimeters in diameter. But the little adapters, when you plug them in, they let you use also TT motors, which are kind of like the large yellow motors that we like. They're very low cost. And also N20, which are the geared down, all metal gear, smaller motors that you see. They're common. I see them on like a lot of Pololu projects, but also other robots. So, yeah, if you see here, this photo, which I think is really nice, you can see on the right, there's the Lego axle. In the middle, there's the N20 metal geared motor. And on the left is the TT large plastic geared motor. So you can use with any of these three. And so it's a really good value because you get one wheel and you can use it for any robotics project.
All right. And with that, we'll see you partially.
Yay!
Let's do it again.
Yes.